Our topic is how to use ultrasonic sensor with the Arduino library. For doing this, I am showing you the steps. Before this, I will show you how the device are working. Okay, let's simulate it. Okay, our device will work in this way. So let's start how I am going to use the Arduino Uno with the ultrasonic library. For this, of course, I will select the Proteus 8 Professional. I am using 8.6. You can use any other version. Okay, let's start with a schematic capture. Go to pick device, and you should pick Arduino. You should pick Arduino Uno R3. Let's select it through double click, and then you should select ultrasonic sensor. But let me tell you that you have to install the ultrasonic sensor library and Arduino Uno library, I mean the Arduino's library, in the Proteus. If you do not install the ultrasonic sensor library and Arduino Uno library, then Arduino's library, then you will never be able to use the ultrasonic sensor and Arduino in the Proteus. I have uploaded a video how to install the Arduino library and ultrasonic sensor in Proteus. You have to just watch it, and then if you install the Arduino library and the ultrasonic sensor, then you will be able to use this ultrasonic sensor and Arduino library like I am using. Okay, so let's install it, and after we have to select it. After this, I will take the potentiometer POT and write, for this I will write POTHG. Okay, now select it, so double click and close it, and now put the Arduino Uno here, potentiometer here, and let's put the ultrasonic sensor here, move it clockwise, give the connection of ultrasonic sensor and Arduino library, the connection of 4 with the trigger. The connection of 4 will be with the echo. Okay, will be with the echo, and 5 will and 5 will be with the trigger. Okay, now now I have to use the potentiometer. Let's rotate it clockwise, give the connection with this, and then I will have to use the ground symbol and of course the power symbol with this potentiometer. Use the power here, connect it. Use the ground symbol, put it here, connect it, and then use the virtual terminal. For this, come here, select virtual terminal, put the virtual terminal here, connect 0 with TXD and 1 with RXD. Okay, you have finished your connection. Now you have to upload the program in the Arduino board, in the Arduino's microcontroller. For this, I will go to Arduino application. I will have to write this program. After writing your program, you have to save your program. For this, come here and let's select save as. I have saved it as the name ultrasonic sensor. You can save it and save it in another name. Okay, now save it. Okay, save. After saving it, you have to done compiling, and after the compiling process, you will upload it. Okay. After uploading it, let's move to Proteus and Professional. Now select the microcontroller, select program file, write %m, write % again, and after writing %s, you will have to open it. Let's open it. You have to modify the date, select today, select Arduino build, open it. Select ultrasonic sensor, you know, hex file, open it, and then give OK. Now the words of ultrasonic sensor, click on it. You will have to select the hex file. Okay, for selecting it, I will write the desktop. I will click on desktop, and you will have to select the Arduino library for Proteus. I am giving the link of downloading Arduino library for Proteus. You will have to download it, and if you keep it in desktop, click on desktop like I have clicked on it, and then Arduino library for Proteus, open it, ultrasonic sensor library, and then library, ultrasonic sensor hex file, open it, and then click on OK. And you have done the most of your job. Now the last job of yours is to watch it whether it is working or not. Let's watch it. Okay, the devices are working. If you increase the resistivity of potentiometer, you will watch it that the distance will increase, and if you decreases the resistivity of potentiometer, you will watch it that the distances are decreases. Okay, and this is the way how you should use the Arduino and the ultrasonics library, and also you can say it that the virtual terminal or the potentiometer together. Thanks for this.